Hello, and welcome to Flowers Daily News. Today, we will be talking about sleep. On to you, Hannah.
Sleep. Everyone does it. Everyone enjoys it. Although, if you're like me, you think it takes way too much time. Like, I would way rather be tired and productive than 110% awake with nothing done. Plus, I mean, isn't that what coffee's for? But moving along. I'm here to tell you why you should sleep, but hopefully you're not sleeping on me, right? Getting your prescribed 8 hours of sleep is not only refreshing, but quite needed for those of you lacking the beauty department. I'm just kidding, of course. But what I'm not kidding about is the side effects of not sleeping. Let's start with the cardiovascular system, since your heart and your blood vessels are pretty important. Obviously, you already know that sleeping refuels your entire body, similar to plugging your phone in every night. But did you know your arteries need sleep to unclog themselves, if you will? Think about it like this. How many of you have had an issue with your phone or your laptop and need to restart it to get it to work again? Sleeping kind of does a similar thing for your arteries and blood vessels. You see, plaque made of fat, cholesterol, calcium, and a bunch of other stuff in blood can harden and clog them over time. Now, you might be thinking, Hannah, I pulled an all-nighter last weekend to binge Netflix. Does that mean my arteries are blocked? Well, not exactly. Plaque buildup is generally pretty slow, so unless you've only been sleeping 2 hours a night for the last 6 months, I'm sure you're going to be fine. Moving on to the heart. I'm sure you're all familiar with something of your own overworking itself and then overheating in exhaustion, from your car to your TV to your 6-year-old Chromebook. It's all happened or bound to happen at some point. Your heart is no different. Without sleep to refuel, it's going to be running in air, or a McDonald's caramel frappe. For people 18 or older, you should have a BPM anywhere from 60 to 100 when resting. If younger, 70 to 100, roughly. If you're not sleeping your body's required amount, then your heart isn't going to have enough energy to beat at the right pace. And along with that, if your arteries are clogging, your heart will have to push harder to get the blood out. Less energy plus more force equals not a good combo. In fact, if you're consistently pushing your heart to overwork itself, it's going to fall into a new heartbeat pattern. And 90% of people that have procedures done to fix their irregular heartbeats have it revert right back shortly after their procedures are done. Now, onto something equally as important as your heart, your nervous system, mainly your brain. It's what's allowing you to watch this video and absorb what I'm saying. But if you're watching this tired, you probably won't remember half of what I say. Truth is, your brain needs sleep to process information and create new memories. That's why you will dream about whatever you were watching or thinking about before you went to bed. It was your brain writing down information for later. Without sleep, your brain has a hard time communicating with itself. While you sleep, your brain not only creates memories, but it also decides what you will forget. When it doesn't have enough energy to create memories, it's going to throw away information, whether it thinks you need it or not. So you shouldn't stay up all night studying for anatomy. Just go to sleep. Along with that, not sleeping can cause rapid mood swings and increase your chances of paranoia, depression, and even violence. Along with your memory being affected, your senses can also be affected. Things like cold or tingling limbs, random pains or itchiness, even hallucinations are not uncommon for those going through sleep deprivation. Two of the most famous cases of sleeplessness are Peter Tripp and Randy Gardner. Gardner went 11 days and 25 minutes without sleep, while Tripp went 200 hours, which roughly equates to 8 days. Both experienced hallucinations and an inability to recognize what they were touching.
Wow, that's crazy to me. Back to you, Hannah.
Wow, interesting news report. Thank you, Hannah. Well, if that doesn't convince you to sleep, then I don't know what will. This was Flowers Daily News. Thank you for tuning in.